ready for this? I'm super excited about our next unit. We're gonna be starting Racket's unit, or you can call it striking unit, anything you want. Number one, you could use any racket in the beginning. You could use a ping pong racket. You can use a pickleball racket, which I have here. This is a beach tennis racket, but it's really, or a paddle tennis racket, really all the same. If you really need something, you could even use a frying pan, because same thing, it's flat, it's a flat surface. You hold it the same way. So really, this is not so much about aerobic capacity like we did before. This is a little bit more about hand-eye coordination, developing your hand-eye coordination for other sports. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna get right into it. I'm gonna tell you the proper grip. Whether you're righty or lefty, it's the same. What we want to do is hold the racket like this, and you're gonna put your hand right on top of the grip, and that's how you're gonna hit with your dominant hand. Some people are lefty, so you're gonna come on top like this. If you're on the ground, if the racket's on the ground, you could just put your hand right on top. Make sure your hands, your fingers are separated, and it's kind of like you're getting a pizza out of an oven, like you're baking a pizza out of an oven, and you're holding it, and you're gonna lift it up. That's basically how you're holding the racket. That's the basic grip. Make sure you're not death gripping it like this and squeezing it really tight. Spread your hands out a little bit, and then just make sure you're nice and light with your grip. When you play tennis in the beginning, you don't want a lot of wrist hinge, okay? You don't want a lot of this. You want to be a little bit more firm with your wrist, so there's not a lot of wrist hinge. And these are called ups, okay? So these are called ups, and we're gonna have an ups contest. What that means is you're gonna see how many you can get by hitting the ball up. And you're just concentrating and watching the ball hitting the middle of this flat racket the whole time. So you're doing as many as you can. And then when you're good at that, you can go to the other side, so your palm is facing the sky, and you could do it this way. So now my palm is facing the sky, and you could do it this way. Put my hand on top. Now I'm ready, I'm watching the ball. Now I'm just doing it nice and easy. A little bit softer. Now I'm gonna do the one with my palm to the sky. I'm gonna turn it over, and I'm really watching the ball. If the ball gets away, I'm moving my feet. I'm always trying to keep it near. Notice I'm not hitting it very hard. Okay, I'm not hitting it hard at all. I'm not flipping it up like this. Okay, I'm hitting it nice and easy so it just comes right back to my racket. I could do it just with the frying pan. So all I'm doing is trying to hit the middle of the frying pan, holding the same grip so my hand's on top. Only thing with this, it's gonna be really difficult to do the ups and do the unders. I'd have to do right in the middle of the frying pan. Looks like I can do it. So you could do anything that's flat. As you can see, I have a frying pan. Pretty cool, huh? So I can do this all day. And you're just trying to make sure you watch that ball to hit the center and middle of whatever surface you're trying to hit. So you're trying to hit the middle, trying to concentrate on the ball. How many can you get? I want to see if you can get 50, 100. I want you to send me your videos and show me. And I want to see you doing this to see how many you can get. Now, as I try to hit the middle, and I'm going to go to the other side. And you see how many you can do. I would try to pick one side or the other. And if you get really good, you could do tricks. Okay, the next one we're gonna do, we just did ups. Now we're gonna do downs. This is all for hand-eye coordination. And this is all to kind of get the racket to see how it feels with the racket, with the ball hitting the racket. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get the same grip and I'm gonna kind of dribble the ball on my racket. So I'm gonna see how many I can get like this. Now, this is a little bit harder than it looks because you have to keep that ball under the strings. So you don't wanna do this and put the ball too hard because then the ball is gonna go everywhere. I'm keeping my wrist firm and I'm keeping it low. Notice I'm not doing it way up here because then the ball's gonna go everywhere. I might even hit the camera person in the face. So I gotta make sure I keep it below my waist and make sure I keep it here. Just keep it nice and steady. And you're gonna see how many you can get of these. Sometimes you can go a little bit faster and you can dribble a little bit faster like this. Okay, you could do a little bit higher. You could do it between your legs like this. Like dribbling a basketball, okay? But usually you wanna just keep it at waist level. Now you could even do it with the pickleball. Okay, I could do it with the pickleball. This is a little more difficult because this doesn't bounce, but I could do it with the pickleball racket. You could do it on a ping pong table. Okay, and I can put that back. Now the ball you have has to bounce. You could do it with this racket. And you're seeing how many you can do. Not a lot of wrist. There's a little bit of wrist, but my wrist is usually staying firm, and I'm trying to keep that ball at the same level. I wanna see if you could do 100 of those. Maybe start off with 15, work your way up, and then again, you're sending me these videos to show me your ups and downs. Again, this is downs. You could do this in the driveway, you could do this in the backyard, any flat surface. Find the same.
I got this feeling inside my bones. It goes electric, wavy when I turn it on. Off from my city, off from my home. We're flying.
You could do it this way. The next stage of that would be what I call flippy floppies. And you flip and you flop and you go to the other side. And you just go from side to side and you see how many you can get like this. When you get really good, you could do, I could be here all day doing this, and you just get as good as you can. And I want you to try to get, maybe start with 15, and then you build up from there. And then I could do flippy floppies again, flippy floppies, and go from side to side. I'm really watching the ball. Most important thing in tennis and any racket sports is watch the ball. Hand-eye coordination, hit the middle of the strings. Notice how light I'm hitting it. It's not really high.
But you, when you dance,
all right, the next one you're going to do is learn how to hit the ball against a wall. You could do this against your garage. You can find a wall anywhere. But remember, you're going to hit it really light and you're not going to hit it hard. So what you're going to do is you're going to hit it just barely against the wall. You're going to be about, I would say, 5 steps from the wall. So you're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're going to put the racket out in front of you with the strings facing the wall. Same grip as I taught you when we did downs. So same grip, put your racket out in front of you so the strings are facing the wall, and you're just gonna barely hit it. Just barely nice and touch. It's like a little baby. Okay, you're just touching it, just barely hitting against the wall, and you're gonna see how many you can get against the wall. Like I said, you could do this against the garage. You can find a surface, you can go down to the park, hopefully with social distancing, and there's nobody there, but you can find a wall, and just hit it nice and easy against the wall to see how many you can get. And you just keep going. Now, when I'm doing this, I wouldn't want to hit it really hard, because if I hit it really hard, it can come back and hit me. Now, I'm not against a wall. I have a fence, so it's just a flat surface that you can find. And I'm just trying, so if you can't find a wall, you're just trying to find a flat surface. Again, I'm trying to do this thing. I have a different ball. Again, you can get these at Target. I think you can get them at sporting goods stores. They're softer, bigger balls that make it easier to bounce. So it's easier to hit in the center of the strings. So again, you're gonna get about 5 steps from your wall. I'm gonna count it off, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You're gonna put your racket out in front of you and you're gonna turn your shoulders. If you're lefty, it's the other way. Turn your shoulders, racket out in front. So I want my racket to be way out in front of my belly, okay? And I'm sideways. I'm gonna put my racket out in front, nice and easy. And all I'm doing is just trying to hit against the fence. Again, I'm not hitting it too hard. Notice how I'm turning my shoulders and I'm seeing how many I can get against the wall. Just nice and easy. How many can you get? Notice how it doesn't quite come off the same as a wall, but it still works. And I have to move my feet. I have to move my feet so I can get to the next one. I have to keep moving. Keep moving your feet. That's where the cardio, that's where the heart work comes in. What do you have? Let's see what you got. I want you to send me your videos. I want to see the wall you're hitting off. I want to see the racket that you're using. What do you got, Brookside? Let's do this. Just want to give you a few activities you can do if your little ones cannot quite do ups and downs yet. As you see, we have Isla.
here. She's in DK. She's just trying to balance the ball on the strings without it touching the edges. She started off by just standing and not letting the ball touch the edges, and now she's moved in to walking around and not letting the ball hit the edges. The little kids sometimes have a hard time with this. It just teaches balance and hand-eye coordination to make sure that ball stays in the center without it hitting the edges. You can also move it into another, instead of hitting against the wall, they can throw it against the wall. They throw it and try to catch it with the same hand they threw it with. Right here, Eyeless catching with two hands. That's okay in the beginning. I would recommend trying to catch it with one hand just to kind of get the idea of the hand-eye coordination of trying to go with the same hand. You can progress this also into doing downs where you hit the ball down and then they try to catch it with the opposite hand the racket is in. So just a few activities. Hope this helps the little ones progress. And I hope to see you soon.
First things first, I'ma say all the words inside my